Good evening. My name is Cameron Fetter, and I work at the Oscars as an archivist. I was recently doing some digging in the Academy vault, and I uncovered some footage that is very nostalgic. We are going to screen something tonight that has not been seen in many, many years. The first ever Oscars in Memoriam segment, remembering some of our classic actors who have since passed away. So, without further ado, lights, cameras, memories.
I am little today.
You are little. Just get up bigly. Get up in a bigger way.
You're also vanishing into the background in a funny way.
Oh, yeah. I made it worse.
We left. Stay right there. Don't move a muscle.
Okay, hold on.
This is how big I'll be.
Do I get to be big today?
Wait, hold on. I'll be big. Oh, I'm at maximum height, actually.
You can be big any day you want to.
If you don't understand.
You guys are down here.
No, that doesn't.
I'm so small.
I'm taking this away from you.
Yeah, that's horrible.
You are not allowed to have this microphone, but I am.
No, nobody's allowed to have it.
Why did we buy this microphone?
Jubio bought that for you for your birthday.
Is that true?
Isn't that?
Did you buy this for me?
Yeah.
That's extraordinarily sweet.
That was like 2 years ago.
That's like a concha. That's how sweet that is.
A concha?
A concha?
A conch shell. Is that what you said?
No, what's that? Is that? No, it's not called a
chancla. Are you thinking of the chancla?
Was a guy I went to elementary school
with. I think a concha is a kind of sweet bread.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is. Look. Oh my God. I was right. I remember having this. There's a Mexican bakery in Wilmington that I used to go to like every once in a while. And I went one time and this always looked so delicious to me.
Concha is mid.
And then I ate it.
It was terrible. Concha is mid.
Why do they make it different colors? They all taste the fucking same.
Is it mid in Mexico or is it just mid here?
It's a little dry. You're supposed to like have it with like coffee.
Oh, so it's like Mexican biscotti.
Because I ate it dry.
So it's not even a food. It's an ingredient. That's what you're telling me.
It's a stirrer.
And that's your... I mean,
you could say the same thing for donuts.
Shut the fuck up. What are you talking about? The same thing for donuts.
You're supposed to...
They make donuts with brides and grooms on top. That's how advanced a donut is.
Yeah.
They make donuts...
A donut is also nowhere near as dry as a concha.
That's true.
A donut isn't even dry at all.
Yeah. My concha is dry.
Some types of donuts might be dry, but that's a failing of a specific donut, exactly. Not the donut as a form.
My concha dries up when I see you.
You have a concha?
Yep.
And it dries up?
Oh, yeah.
When you see me? I mean, that's nice.
So you're saying I guess you have one.
I wouldn't want you to get really wet when you saw me.
Is that some kind of slang in Mexico for pussy? Concha?
Is girls getting wet like boners?
Do they get it where they have to stand up in front of class?
Yeah, and they have a wet ass.
They have
a wet ass because they've been sitting in it the whole time.
Yeah.
But in the mornings, do you sit there and you're like, oh my God.
No, on the bus at 7 a.m.
When you take a plane, are you like, oh fuck, why am I randomly wet as fuck on this plane?
Do girls get randomly wet?
I think they do.
We need this info.
We have never had a girl on the show.
That's not true.
That's not true.
We've had a few girls on
the
show.
We've had thousands on the girl show.
On the girl show.
We're the girl show.
No, we're not that.
We're the girl show now, apparently, according to Caleb, that we've had 1,000 girls on the show.
I'm just curious about women's bodies, and I just want to learn
randomly
more.
Wet,
we should just have one. We should have, like, Dr. Ruth or somebody come on and explain every single...
Who's Dr. Ruth?
She died.
She's dead? Then who's the old lady who talks about sex?
She died and she passed on the Supreme Court to the conservatives.
Oh, you're right.
She was being bloody selfish and decided that she wanted glory.
She decided she wanted the glory of officiating a wedding.
Yeah. That is,
and it gave her COVID 7000.
That is so funny, actually. That
her soul teleported to Jupiter.
Those people's wedding decimated
It was not that their wedding that killed Ruth Bader Ginsburg. It was me.
It was their wedding that killed Roe v. Wade.
It was me.
It was Cameron.
I dropped a germ in her mail slot.
Yep. He dressed up like a mailman, and he had a germ in a little vial.
I had one germ. I had it in a tweezers.
A vial of a germ.
I was holding a germ with tweezers.
Green germ.
Let me out. Yeah.
And he said, buddy.
Listen, germ. There's a really old lady.
Don't fuck this up, germ.
What if the germ had blue hair and was a liberal and he didn't want to do it?
Well, that's why he screened it. He made sure it was a really nasty Mucinex germ and not a SJW germ.
Uh-huh.
By the way,
COVID-19.
Dr. Fauci has been creating SJW germ.
They got green germs on Mucinex. This was a red germ.
Oh, whoa.
And I'm not just saying that because it was politically red end of the spectrum, but because it was dangerous.
Yeah.
Yes.
And also very hot.
Exactly like strep
finger. And it turned red. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Why would you choose red to be your politician color?
Right? Well, I guess red means strength.
But red doesn't...
When you look at color theory,
I think of blood, and not just that. I think of Nazi Germany, Hitler.
Yeah.
I think of...
The Rising Sun.
Yeah, that's true. They should have thought of that when they were founding the...
Mm-hmm. The Republican
Party. I guess it just makes sense because it's, you know, Republican red.
Yeah,
then
Republican
it's Democrat
red,
blue. It should
Democrat
have been, well, Democrat
denim.
Dark blue, denim.
Democrat denim.
Because they're
Republican
so...
Republican red.
And you know what? I like denim.
Whoa.
Okay.
Yeah.
Weird.
That's right. I'm a lib.
Okay, American Apparel.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
See, I would have done either white or black.
Yeah.
White versus black is how you would have done politics?
No, that's not a good idea.
Maybe. Oh, actually, here's a great idea.
Why not all the same color?
You just said you want a rainbow party.
Because they're the same exact party.
Rainbow is all one color to you?
Yeah, well, it's every color in one.
No.
Or brown, I guess, is that.
What are you saying?
We should have done a brown party.
Yeah. So there's the green party.
Yeah, which, by the way... Just because I want you to have a new color doesn't mean you need to name your party after the color, asshole.
Yep. And just because I voted for you when I was 17 doesn't mean you can send me mail.
Voted when you were 17? You did voter fraud.
I did voter fraud.
What?
No, I was 19. When was the election? It was 2015.
I think I was 18, so you must have been 18 as well.
Yeah, I just turned 18 because my birthday is on the 23rd. So that was my
first
election.
Are you guys excited for politics to come out? God damn it. The Hungry video was not even real.
Yeah. No, it's real. It's real.
It's
real. It's real. Just say it's real.
I saw a Forbes.com article about
this. Don't believe Forbes.
It got me fucked up, man.
Don't
believe Forbes. The best part of the video is with whoever's voicing it over. They don't say mmm. They say mmm.
Mm-hmm.
Mmm.
Hungry.
Ah, that's the secret.
That was the one thing.
Hungry is the obvious funny part, but mmm is so funny. When you see
I love this about you, that your mind just always goes to the details.
Mm-hmm.
You're like r/movie details. You're like
r/movie details.
That's a good Reddit that you should make.
Just,
is r/viral video details.
Just imagine those
details.
Like, I'm so hungry.
I'm completely hungry.
Hungry.
We need a...
See, that's... But anyway, that goes back to what we were saying. This guy, Ron DeSantis, he's not even funny.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The funniest thing is not even him.
Uh-huh.
Somebody else did it.
Somebody was dunking on his ass.
That's all I'm going to say. Bring him... I'm going to do my hands like this. Bring him back.
Bring him back.
Make him just something. I don't care what he is. Uh-huh. I just want him to be in something again. And have to... I don't care... Again, I don't care what it is. It doesn't have to be the number one spot. It can be any other spot.
He should get the unplugged controller.
He should be like the queen in...
Who?
He
shall not be named.
Donald Trump needs to be a queen...
He who shall not be elected.
A queen-style part like head of the state.
Yeah,
right.
A figurehead.
A figurehead. Yeah. Where we made, and I'm fine to pay. I'll pay for him. I don't give a fuck.
Sure. Whatever. Yeah. I'll buy his.
No, because you know who's really gonna pay.
Robes. Fine.
His
whatever.
You know who's really gonna pay? Is women in POC.
I don't think if he was the king.
Okay,
he
then
could
we'll
go
have
up
it. Well, then
whatever.
we'll just get rid of all the women in POC in the government, and then he won't have anyone to mess with, right?
Oh, that's a good
that's
point.
A solution,
he
right?
He can't assault any women if you get rid of every single one in all of politics.
Oh, yeah, if you make him his own office.
No, we just clean
so
out.
So it's an office that's full.
Here's
of
what honkies. I think: we build him an office inside the Lincoln
in
Memorial.
Uh huh.
He should be in space.
No. Do they have a little door under his seat?
He should have a Matrix-style room where he has a screen of everything he needs to see.
Did you just say they have a little menorah under?
Do they have a little door under Lincoln's seat in the memorial?
I don't actually know. I don't know anything. Everything I've learned about Washington, D.C. is from National Treasure.
I was just about to say, I feel like if they had a door under there would be some kind of crazy secret, maybe his head. Yeah. Futurama style.
I think, okay, I honestly
think... And only the 1% get to talk to Lincoln.
I honestly think if I could be... If I had access to any single building in the entirety of the restricted United States, uh-huh. I don't think I would do Area 51. I think I would do the Smithsonian because I get that. I bet they got some crazy shit.
I would put on Jim Henson's sweater.
Yeah.
They have different butterflies that we've never seen.
I would go
ship.
Into yeah. the CDC, and I would be going in and just opening
all the
doors all the
viruses,
and walking around.
Yeah.
What's this?
They don't keep the
What's
viruses
this?
Behind a door.
They keep them behind three doors.
What do you? Yeah. What
they
else would they keep
it
them
in
behind?
A
one
box.
Door, one
well,
door
to
decontaminate, and then two
then
doors.
They have the gloves so they can play with the virus.
Yeah.
That does seem very fun.
Yeah.
I remember...
I would love to see like what putting like a germ in somebody's body does to them.
It does. We already know. You know what that
is. I would love to be the guy at the CDC whose job is to walk up to people with like the bear mace and just spray a whole virus
That's not
at
a
person. They wear a hazmat suit. The person is sitting in a padded room and is like, oh, thank God. Thank God, you guys.
Thank God I'm being bear sprayed.
Thank God somebody's coming in here to help me. I don't know where I am. I don't know how I got here.
They were
and then you just spray them with the virus. And they're
have,
like,
you guys
oh,
ever
no.
been, have you guys ever
I'm in
needed
the virus room.
Money bad enough that you were thinking of doing a human trial?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you don't get paid that much.
You
That's
don't.
The problem. You get paid like $200 and maybe
Look,
you
I
die
mean,
and maybe you're forever red.
I did a human
that
trial. Look at me.
I did some research stuff in
now
high
I'm
school.
Shrunk.
Did you get, like for high school though?
No.
You did like it for
I did,
money?
They paid me.
What'd you do?
They MRI'd me for one that I would think was about, I think I was the control group for one that was about alcohol. Like I didn't drink and they wanted to MRI. So they MRI'd me. And that might have even been in middle school because I think I was listening to American Idiot in the MRI machine. That's my.
They let you listen to fucking music.
They,
you,
they give
music
you. They put a
it.
CD into and they play because it makes terrifying noises.
Yeah,
so
it does.
They play music inside.
Yeah.
It.
Well, I mean that's kind of a cheat.
And then
code,
I did a
though.
Bunch of ones that were just like I don't even know or remember what they're for, but it's just a bunch of ones. Where they ask you a bunch of questions and you do all the like yes, no.
Oh,
really?
I got a
whatever.
Survey taken when I was 8 years old. Down at the public pool was my mom, like, I think she did it so I would have, like, $50 for my birthday. But
can
like,
your kid do a cannonball?
Who can do the best belly flop in the entire pool?
But I remember, I'm pretty sure the woman who was, like, proctoring this survey was asking me about Taco Bell. If I remember correctly, I don't remember what it was.
You took
I
a
just
Taco Bell survey.
I
he got put in a machine.
Pool, I
and
swear
you took
to
a Taco
God,
Bell survey at the machine at the pool,
at
and you're
the
saying
machine.
These are the same thing.
These are similar. Yeah,
these aren't similar at all.
These are similar because they were testing. He was the control for an alcohol test. That's
and
the
you
same.
Took a survey
they were
for a coupon.
That is,
they were mapping
that is the
my brain
same,
chemicals.
That is the same thing. Well,
you did
given,
a, you
making
did
a 13 year
brand.
Old a 13 year old being made to like. Being the control,
being made to talk about Taco Bell,
13-year-old being the control for an alcohol test is nothing.
You asked
about
you were asked about the Mexican pizza. You're probably why they got rid of it.
Have you ever been in an MRI? It gave me scars permanently.
I've never been in it. Really?
No.
Oh,
but it is scary. It's really scary.
I don't trust any machines.
Especially because you know if you have any metal on you, you will die.
Oh. I don't think that I would do.
I have metal fillings.
If I had cancer, I would not be doing radiation. I would not be doing chemotherapy. Yeah.
I would Breaking Bad it.
Yeah, dude.
I have
that shit.
Fillings.
It's too
and
expensive.
By that, I just mean I wouldn't go to the doctor. That's all I mean.
Yeah. Well, he goes to the doctor. The
but
doctor
only a
says,
few times.
I don't
stops.
Go to the doctor like at all.
I haven't been in a long time.
Yeah. Me neither.
Last time I went, my doctor.
I want to put her on blast, to be honest, but I ain't going to do it.
Wait, no. Talk your shit. Talk your shit.
No, he's being a big person right now.
No. I want to hear about it.
I have another appointment with her in August. I'll do it after that.
Okay.
See if she's got one more chance.
If she sees this and I'm going off and I come in for this appointment, it could get dangerous.
You have a new type of cancer.
Yeah, something could happen.
She's going to inject you.
I told you what she did to me. She put me in a trap.
What the?
We talked about this
before. I actually don't remember this. What happened?
That she put me into a glass box.
Yep.
Oh, I kind of remember this, but it's a bit...
He was put into a glass box, and then he walked out, and he wasn't supposed to leave.
Yeah.
I don't remember
this. No,
they put
me in a glass box. I told her I had asthma.
Oh, they made you breathe.
And she was like, well, I'm not sure if you have asthma or not. And I've had asthma my whole life. Yeah. And she's like, well, I'm going to have to do some tests on you. And she did saw trap tests on me for a day.
Really?
And then the results were, yep, you have asthma. And then they charged me hundreds of dollars for it.
Holy shit.
That's bullshit, dude.
I
hate going to the doctor and the dentist in New York City.
I hate going to the doctor and the dentist anywhere in the entire world.
I hate the dentist a lot.
Me too.
But the dentists in New York, it's all it's either like the tiniest private practice and you can't tell because it like just looks like somebody's building, or it's like some place that like has just pictures of teeth everywhere and then like things that are like the...
I'm never going to find a new dentist again in my life.
Dude,
if I can't go back to my family dentist, I'm never going to the dentist again in my life.
I got to go to New Hampshire to do my dental stuff.
People didn't go to the dentist for hundreds of years.
I need the dentist pretty bad because one of my crowns was put in incorrectly and I didn't know, and there's been food getting stuck in there.
How fancy are you?
The food be like, help!
Yep.
Mm-hmm. That's what it'd be saying.
Help, get us out!
Yep.
No, then I got that. I cracked that tooth, and I've had a temporary filling put in there.
And his tooth with the crown be like, my royal subjects! Talking to the other teeth.
I wish.
And
the other teeth be like, yes, master.
Yes, master king of all the teeth.
I wish I had a king tooth that told them what to do. Then they would say,
your problem is you have
fight
multiple
all the
king
infections.
Tooth.
Yeah, you have a warring, power struggle. Yeah, you have
that's
true. Feudalism
this
going
side
on
of my
in your mouth
and this side of my mouth are warring.
You have a blood mouth and a crypt side of your mouth with teeth.
Dude, when I had that infection on my wisdom tooth, that was so crazy.
His wisdom tooth be like,
no, his wisdom zombie. Tooth be like, well, he's thinking.
Oh, yeah.
Well.
Yeah, I was thinking the infection part.
Well, he can't think.
I can't even think. I'm infected.
Because of my infection.
I had a dream about Saw the other night.
Uh-huh. They're making a new one.
Really?
Saw X.
Maybe they'll include the trap that I thought of in my dream.
Could be about them. Could we make the whole movie
different?
Well,
this was
something
where I had this thought, and then have you ever had a thought, and then you have a dream about it?
No, yeah.
I had this thought, and then I had a dream that was Saw, and it was the Saw trap was that I had to explain stuff to my dad was the Saw trap. So I had to explain like a 240 hertz monitor to my dad or else I die.
Mm-hmm.
And it really scared me when I woke up.
Yeah.
Well, I woke up crying.
You would wake up because the punishment was that your dad thought you were gay.
I'm in the bear thing.
Uh-huh.
And then he's like, call your dad on the phone and try to explain to him a high refresh rate gaming monitor.
I don't think I could explain anything to anybody if I was under threat of death.
I don't know. That whole thing just seems like your dad would just go, oh, okay.
But I had to really get him to explain it. That's why it's scary. He takes a test at the end.
Oh, got it. Okay.
Which that is scary. The idea of having to explain.
Are you allowed to say that you're going to die if he doesn't explain it right?
Because my dad would get too nervous. He would keep him from doing it.
Right.
Or the scariest part is what if my dad's like, okay, I don't care. What if he takes this as an opportunity to let me go and pass on to the next world?
Right.
And he doesn't give a fuck about me.
Maybe since you can't tell him you're going to die or that Saw has you, maybe he's like, yeah, I'll do the test. And he doesn't do it. I'm at work. I'll do the test
later.
That's
what he would do, actually, knowing my dad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He would be on the golf course.
And you have to basically be like, no, this is so important.
There's different things. What if you called 911 and your dad picked up?
My dad would be chill.
I would hang up and call back to talk to someone else.
I would too.
Yeah.
It's a conflict of interest.
Yeah.
Well, the job of a 911 operator is to decide whether the emergency is important or not and whether to send people.
True. Mm.
And my dad's always going to send people.
My dad would probably not send anybody. He would be like,
so if I call 911,
if I send an ambulance, it's going to be too expensive. You're just going to have to figure this out.
I'm just because I can't really figure out whether I should be calling 911 or not because it's too close to home. So I'm calling 911. I'm like, I'm out of bread. I have PB, I have J, I got no bread.
I saw a guy.
The 911 operator should say, this is not an emergency, you may hang up. But I call my dad. My dad says, you should go to the grocery store. He's tying up the lines.
Oh, God. I saw a guy the other day, and I think he was faking dying on the ground.
Yeah?
I saw a guy who I thought was dead.
We were walking by this guy, and he was like, and normally I would think he was dying in a real way, but he was on the ground, and he was completely lifeless and not moving at all. And
he just kept doing this?
Well, but there was a crowd, and at first I was like, holy shit. But then there was a crowd around him that seemed to be like his family, and every single one of them, nobody was helping them. They were all just arms crossed looking at him, kind of like tapping their feet like, oh my God, what the fuck is this? Like saying, like pointing at him, like yelling at him in Spanish, going like pointing at him and screaming. Yeah.
That's
and then
so
the
sick.
Fire department showed up, and all of his family, instead of like waiting to see what happened to him, they just walked away.
Yeah.
So I told my wife, I was like, I think that guy's dying, and she was like, wait, no, that guy's faking it. and then we got a little bit closer, and he was as they're like loading him into the ambulance, he was fully like eyes open, pretending to be a dead guy for a while, and then they started loading him into the ambulance, and he goes like this, he goes, oh, and starts grabbing his stomach like he has a stomachache. So I just don't know if this guy, like, if they told, and it was right in front of a bank, so I don't know if he was like, somebody was like trying to get him to write a check or something, and he was just decided to fake die, which is a pretty good
money.
Idea.
You have to get money out to pay your rent, and he's just like, oh.
And, well, first you try being completely lifeless, and then you realize at some point, you're going to have to pretend to be alive again.
Yeah.
So your first instinct is to instantly die. But at some point, there needs to be some kind of symptom that you're actually having. So you hold your stomach, you go,
well, that's how
I
would get out of it. I would instantly pretend to be dead. And then when the ambulance got there, because I didn't want to pay the bill, I'd just be like, oh my God, I'm sorry, guys. I thought I was dead.
I died for a couple minutes there, but God told me to come back. God told me to come back and tell you that heaven is completely different.
Sorry,
now.
I got confused. I thought I was dead, but I'm not.
I actually completely lived.
Yeah, I lived.
Well, that's the only thing that made me think.
I was like, I'm a new guy. A new soul just came into my
life. What happened to that dead guy?
What the hell?
Oh, man, who am I? Who am I now?
What the fuck? I've been jumping around different bodies.
These people look, do you guys want to be my family?
You look like me.
Do you guys want to be my family? But you have to forgive every debt that this old guy used to
I'm
have.
Not the same guy. Yeah.
I'm a different guy. I didn't do any of that shit.
And I'm young.
Yep.
So I'm ready to fuck.
And I'm from London.
I don't care about it. It's okay that I said that in front of you guys because I don't know you.
Yep. I'm back and you're my daughter. I'm going to fuck all your friends right now because I'm a brand new guy.
I'm going to marry that woman.
I'm Zac Efron from 2009.
Oh my God.
I was reincarnated.
Oh my
I got
God,
sent to this guy's
movie.
Body. Oh, the one where him and Vince Vaughn switch bodies?
No, Matthew Perry.
Shut up.
It was Matthew Perry. Vince Vaughn is a different man entirely.
He's the same.
They are not the same.
He's the same.
He's the same to me.
One of them is more sarcastic than the other.
They're both sarcastic.
They're both very sarcastic guys.
Vince Vaughn. Have you guys ever seen a picture of young Vince Vaughn?
Yeah, he looked good.
He was hot.
Crazy. Yeah, dude, in Psycho?
He was so hot.
Psycho remake? He was a good looking guy.
Dude, in Swingers? Oh, he's good looking.
A real good looking
guy. And then now he's, I hate to say it, he gives me Fred Claus vibes.
He does. He's doing cool-ass movies with S. Craig Zahler, though. Have you seen any of that? Like Brawl and Cell Block 99 Dragged Across Concrete.
No, I hear Cell Block 99 is cool, though.
Those movies are
His
fucking sick.
His name is S. Craig, or is it S. Dot Craig?
S. Dot Craig.
Okay.
But you don't say the dot. It's just an initial.
Yeah, S. Dot Craig.
That would help me. I thought his name was S. Craig. I was like, oh, who is this? Who is
this? You should watch Dragged Across Concrete. That movie's so cool.
Is it about being odd?
It's about two cops who they do police brutality. It's Mel Gibson and Vince Vaughn. They do police brutality at the beginning.
This is a guy's
movie. They get in trouble.
Ah!
And then they're like, fuck this. We need to make some money on the side. So they go and try and stop a bank heist.
They get in trouble for brutalism?
I know. And the police chief's like, if it were up to me, I wouldn't do shit, but you've been caught one too many times.
Whoa.
Like it's so the politics of the movie are so evil. It's so sick.
It's cool.
It's so fucking cool.
You know what Vince
And it
Vaughn,
takes place it takes place in a fictional US city called Bulwark.
Bulwark what? Where Bulwark where?
They don't say.
It's gotta be the Midwest.
Yeah.
So cool.
Vince Vaughn was in this movie a couple years ago. It was made by the guy who made all these skate videos, then tried to make like these kids pay $700K to get their footage back. Like you try to make 16-year-old kids pay him $700K because he's got like a Pharrell endorsement and he did this crazy like Doritos commercial where he's like, his skate company was doing a collab with Doritos, and he was like, you know, the triangle represents so much, and like just doing shit like that. But Vince Vaughn plays the dad.
He did Phil Jackson?
What's that?
The triangle?
I don't know. We should watch that video of him talking about the Doritos stuff, because it's like the Doritos merch is like little doodles he made, mm-hmm. and it looks like absolute horse shit. But Vince Vaughn plays the dad in his movie that's about a teenager going pro skating, and he dresses like a 50s greaser for some reason. No, like a 50s like soche for some reason.
For some reason. Because it's cool.
No, it looks really bad.
Shut up.
It's that kid from... I guess he the reason he got this movie made was because he was like the consultant on mid-90s. He like Jonah Hill.
Me neither.
Hey, you I know what?
I know your ass on mid-90s in the theater.
No, yep, I didn't see it in the theaters. I saw it on Showtime.
And I bet you brought your board.
No.
You did.
I
you
will
held,
say,
you held it by your tray. No, grabbed it.
I will say the mid-90s is correct.
Now he can say it because Jonah Hill has been eaten by a shark.
I've been saying that's
finally.
Been bad forever.
Yeah.
I've been saying
that's
bad.
So why haven't you been saying anything about Jonah Hill?
Because I don't know too much about him. I know that he's fat.
You
are mistaken,
you
my friend.
He was
really
fat,
mistaken.
Then skinny, then fat again.
And now he's as skinny as a rail.
And then fat
and
again.
And guess what
happens?
Guess what happens with skinny guys? They do inappropriate stuff in relationships.
Mm-hmm.
They really do. And Cameron, I hate to say it, you're as thin as a fucking beanpole.
It happens when you go from fat to
that's,
skinny.
That's why we've been calling you fat, to make it, to get that out of your brain.
Yep.
To get what out of my brain?
Your misconduct.
My misconduct.
Your sexual
I do think that
desire.
Guys who go fat to really skinny are dangerous.
Well, because it's like
the other way around,
reincarnation.
Though?
It's like waking up and being
I don't
like,
mean necessarily dangerous in a relationship way. I think they just are in every sense of the word dangerous.
Skinny too fat. The real paper
skinny,
thin
skinny
to fat guy.
Fat to skinny.
That's a good guy.
Skinny to fat is a good man.
Yeah.
That's a great man.
That just means your life got better. Uh-huh. You're as jolly as a horse.
That means that you learned about maybe like different kind of ethnic foods.
Exactly. Now
Jonah Hill should be in like the...
That's what that means.
Jonah Hill is like the textbook weight change guy.
You wake up, you eat five slices of paneer cheese every single morning because you're trying to broaden your horizons.
Because you thought it was tofu because of the texture, and
exactly.
You didn't realize it's just
cheese.
Yeah.
That's
funny. They would use Jonah Hill to teach in a weight change class. They would say, look at this example. This is what happens. This is the model.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. This he grew out that beard. There's like videos of him like surfing, and he's snaking everyone.
What is, just shut up, man.
He's
what does
snaking
mean?
Him snaking.
Yes. What do you mean? Is he doing that?
You said you surfed as a kid. I thought you would know.
What, snaking? I surfed like 4 times when I was 8 years old.
Snaking is when you like cut off someone's wave.
No.
No, wait, their wave?
Yeah.
How are they going to get another
one? Getting in front of somebody and ruining their shit.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Blood.
Yeah.
That would be if Jonah Hill did that.
That
to
is
me,
a surfer's greatest nightmare.
Imagine you're like a dude who surfs every day in like L.A. Then all of a sudden, fucking Jonah Hill is cut like snaking you, cutting you off.
I'd probably be
you'd be pissed.
No,
you'd be so mad.
I'd probably be so chill that I wouldn't give a fuck.
Me too.
Yeah, that's true. You
I'd
are
probably
a
be so
dude,
fucking.
You that's
are
crazy, dude.
I'd probably be so high on opium
that, Jonah Hill,
that I wouldn't even know.
What is that, Superman?
I'm in a movie, dude.
Dude.
Yeah, I wouldn't give a fuck.
I love Superman.
That's the thing. You can abuse surfers all you want.
Yeah.
That's why Jonah Hill tried it. But he didn't realize that this lady was a poser.
Yeah.
She wasn't even chill.
She was a kook.
She was a kook. Wait, no. She's probably a nice lady. Probably a nice, a fine lady.
Yeah.
I'm breaking my silence about Jonah Hill.
I don't think she sounds like that. I'm going to be honest. I don't know how that voice is funny to me. That voice is so stupid.
It's the funniest voice in the world.
Oh, no. He's a sick puppy, though.
He is not right.
No. Here's the thing. I don't understand.
He's using therapy speak, dude.
I don't know why more actors who get caught doing cannibalism. Oh, have you guys watched the Army Hammer documentary?
There's a documentary.
It's I think it's on HBO or Netflix, and it's called like The Hammer Effect or something like that.
I think it's called the Hammer Effect.
I don't know. It's some stupid ass name about his name.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I haven't watched it yet. I haven't watched it yet because I don't want it to, the reason I haven't watched it is that I don't want it to be demystified.
Yeah, it's going to be so much less interesting than you
think. That's the one.
Because if he had done anything cool, like actually eat anything, we would know about it.
Exactly.
I really
don't want to watch it and find out that he was like,
I mean, he was just abusing. A weird kinky guy who was abusive and wanted to say weird sexual stuff.
I wanted
to
stay him thinking he's Dracula in my brain. I don't want it to be anything but that. If it's anything but that, it's really going to make me sad.
Was he in 50 Shades of Grey?
No.
Oh.
No, he was in, I think,
He was in, I think,
He was being... What did you send me the other day? Would you rather go to prison for life or be the driving
or be stuck as the driving crooner forever?
Yeah, that's a pretty easy decision. Yeah. But
I was sending Cameron some hypotheticals the other day and he didn't even message me back.
Okay. I was asleep, but he texted me all night.
You wake up in the morning and you answer them. I asked him. He did answer one. What? I said PlayStation versus Xbox. Okay. And he said PlayStation.
Cringe.
And then I said pizza or Crunchwrap.
No
answer.
Asleep.
Pizza.
And then he hours later, while I was still asleep, emphasized the question and then sent another one.
How long did you sleep? And how long were you awake?
He sent them in the middle of the night.
Let me look.
You know how he texts.
Time, he always gets home from something very drunk and texts you the worst hypothetical question ever.
It's not the worst. How is that the worst?
Crunchwrap.
Pizza versus those aren't even equivalent.
That's nothing. That's nonsense.
No,
eggs versus baked potatoes.
You just wanted to make my phone buzz at 3 a.m.
Foods at all.
You see why I'm not answering?
No,
these?
That was at okay. You were not asleep at 9:36 p.m.
I probably was. I've been having some trouble sleeping.
Chicken nuggets or tacos?
That one is the closest to an equivalent food.
If I wake up and I see that you were texting me that in the middle of the night and I wasn't responding and you emphasized it, I'm not responding to you. You're not getting that.
I don't get why you wouldn't want to answer these. Oh, then he said it's crazy to watch Amanda Bynes clips and take in how effervescent of a performer she was and how she totally, her surrealist brand of humor took over my generation. Literally human analog to SpongeBob, an incredible contribution to culture. She deserves the greatest care and respect. What is that from?
Something I thought of. I don't remember. I copied and pasted that from somewhere.
Amanda Bynes, she used to have it like that.
Yeah, she was
funny.
Dude,
Amanda Bynes was funny as hell. You know what was crazy?
Who the fuck
said that? There is a sketch on the Amanda Show I remember. I remember.
Yep.
Yep, Maha, Tony Pajamas. But I remember being 6 years old and... like I didn't realize like it was supposed to be a parody of a commercial, and I saw Meatloaf Crunch and I was like, I like meatloaf, I like cereal, that's a perfect combination. I wanted to eat Meatloaf Crunch so bad.
What was it, Mad TV or Amanda Bynes show, the Amanda Show rather, that had the the Amanda Show that had the the soap opera
Moody's Point
used to make me cry.
What was it? The dad was stuck in a hot air balloon?
It literally would make me cry every time it came on. I was such an emotional child.
Wow.
They should not be allowed to do that, man.
What? Make a fake Dawson's Creek?
The part where her dad's in the... That's sad.
It's not that sad.
He's stuck. He's going to fucking die.
No. Doesn't her dad... No, her mom's in the hot air balloon.
That's
what
it was.
And her dad loses his big toe or something. Yeah. And that's like a huge...
Oh, God.
I remember.
It's honestly making me
Moody's
want to cry
point
just thinking about
so
Moody's Point.
I didn't realize how much I remember of Moody's Point. That is crazy.
Dude, just the idea that your mom or any parent, really, if you have.
My mom is
stuck
in a hot air balloon. Bro, I am eating chips every meal.
You would not feel good about that if your mom was stuck in a hot air balloon somewhere way above the
stratosphere.
I would
feel good for the first 2 days.
No, you
That's
wouldn't.
That's Jimmy
dude.
Neutron movie.
That's
vibe.
Jimmy Neutron movie.
You're ripping it
you
off.
You just copied Jimmy Neutron's a movie. Great.
I watched that movie so many times.
That movie made me cry too.
No, that made you know what? Also,
what part of it made you
also
cry?
Made
the
me hungry.
When Sheen pees in the shower.
Uh huh.
Who the hell is Sheen?
You know what?
What are you talking, Sheen? You think that's a name?
You know what made Shut me up. Real hungry though was seeing those green guys turn into eggs, turn into fried eggs.
The end where Carl eats the egg.
I thought that.
What is that? What is that egg holder that he eats the egg out of?
Oh, that's a British holder? Thing. Yeah, it's for soft boiled eggs. You can dip them in the piece of toast.
Y'all remember Poultra?
What
the big chicken monster?
Yeah,
that was so cool.
I remember Sepultura,
and it goes down.
Yeah,
one of my mom's.
Your mom
friends,
was in Sepultura?
No, one of my mom's friends. I told him that I liked like Black Sabbath when I was 9, and he showed me Sepultura.
They're sick.
Yeah, I never listened to them though.
They're cool.
He was a grown man who had snake bites.
That's the kind of guy
I haven't seen snake bites in a while, man.
Me neither, but they are on the way back, I think.
I think the last time I saw snake bites might have been in high school.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's probably been snake bites and a Monroe.
I mean, you can see, I saw someone with a Monroe the other day.
That's not a good thing. You ever know anybody who had the girls who get the dimple piercing?
Amanda Bynes.
Oh, yeah, true.
You knew her?
I knew her, personally.
I knew of her. Yeah. But I didn't know her.
Friend
we
of
ran
a friend.
In some of the same circles, yeah. but we never yeah. crossed paths.
We were hanging out in hipster clubs in 2012.
Yeah,
with the Weeknd.
You weren't hanging out with hipsters.
I was in these hipster clubs in 2012.
I would
in
see
New
her
York
going
City.
To
I was
one
doing
door.
Indie sleaze crap.
I would be in a hallway. I'd see her going to one door, and I'd be going to another door. And then I'd come out. She'd be going out across the hallway into another door, and then I'd like go into that door, and she'd come out to another one. And then down the hallway.
Then I would think crap I would like think that. I'd see her. Then I'd turn around. And then it would be Penelope Taint.
Who? Her last name's Taint?
Penelope from Amanda Show.
Oh, shiz.
Her last name was Taint, which funny Nella AF Taint. To get that on to TV.
That's like Poker Face.
Mm-hmm.
Which you listen to that now, this song should not have been on the airwaves.
This lady's pretending to be having sex with a woman.
Fuck her face?
No.
Yeah.
You're thinking of If You Seek Amy.
No, Poker Face. She says...
Britney Spears says...
Britney Spears.
No, Poker Face is about a woman having sex with a guy and pretending it's a woman.
But she says fuck her face.
No.
Yeah, she admitted that she said this.
She said this.
She did a. Lady, she said this.
Lady Gaga.
Lady Gaga. Lady Gargle.
Lady Gaga.
Face.
Fuck it a face.
Yeah, isn't that awful?
Wow.
And
that
got
really changes my whole perspective.
That's
on
like
the song.
How Fall Out Boy got away with saying goddamn on the radio.
Mm-hmm.
This ain't a scene. It's a goddamn arms race.
I remember that.
That
one.
Was
That's
crazy.
A good song.
No, it's not.
That's a good song.
No.
If You Seek Amy, though, that was on the radio.
I remember that one.
You say that
if
one
you
fast
seen
enough.
Amy.
F-U-C-K me.
I would not. I never thought Britney Spears was hot, man. Even when she was 17, and making those music videos or whatever. I didn't think she was hot. Well, I was younger.
I thought she was
that,
weird.
Yeah, that's true.
I didn't like her.
I thought she was.
I loved Britney
never
Spears.
Never did it for me.
Yeah, I didn't even
I
like
was
her
more
music.
Of an NSYNC fan.
I loved her music.
Wow.
You did not love her music.
I did.
All right.
Drive me crazy.
Okay.
Cameron, what did you prepare for us today that we don't know about?
So today, if you have looked.
I haven't
is
looked.
The, I'm not talking to you.
Shut up.
Is the 250th episode of Podcast About List. And, yep. Oh, wait, hold on.
That means we're halfway to 300.
Hold on. We're halfway there, guys. 500, we end.
You say halfway to 300?
Yeah.
If we started at 200, yeah.
We're halfway to 200. Half of 200 is 250.
And half of 200 is 250?
Half of that is plus 50. If you're looking at it like it's a dollar.
If you're looking at
if
it.
If you're looking
at
it.
Like it's a dollar.
If you're looking at it like it's a dollar.
Right.
2.50. That's 2.5.
Right.
Plus another half, which is 50.
Right.
Would be 300.
He's right half that we only what? Have one more half until
of,
we get to 300.
Yeah, half of something.
Half. Well, half is 50. Or
I'm,
five.
It
or
makes
any
sense
number.
In my head. So then
I
will say it.
But you did say still say halfway to 300 when I said 250.
We're halfway to 300.
From 200.
From 200.
We're giving him a hard time for this. He makes sense. It's not. He's not a genius. No, he never claimed to be a genius. He doesn't have to know.
I've never claimed to ever be a smart person.
It's just a funny thing to say.
It's not that funny of a thing to say.
I don't even know why we're. This is a waste of our time. Because mm-hmm. it
he,
made sense.
He's getting all. He's getting anal retentive.
Getting anal retentive.
Wow. And metrosexual.
Yeah.
I'm not metrosexual.
People used to say anal retentive and metrosexual every single day for about 5 years.
Anal retentive then became, oh, he's so OCD about that.
And metrosexual became autism. When people say that guy is... People, we used to just, if somebody didn't know how to match their clothes, you'd say they're metrosexual. Now you say that guy's autistic.
Last night, my girlfriend said that she thinks that I have autism. Because I was stimming and I didn't realize it.
What were you stimming in?
I was sitting there just going. Min-min-min-min-min.
This fucking bitch. You're singing? You were stimming. You were singing.
Yeah, but I guess I was doing it for really
long.
You're
doing Patrick Lely Lee in the middle of the day, and she thinks that you're autistic for that?
I was doing it a lot. I was doing it a lot. I was in the other room. Just doing that.
I've had the Grinch song stuck in my head for 2 weeks. That's not this. I'm not stimming. I'm singing my song.
I don't know. I think
you're not autistic.
I think that I should take a quiz right now on a website.
No.
I think that I should diagnose myself.
All right, explain
myself.
The 250th episode. What are we doing?
So let me ask you guys a question.
Uh-huh.
What's the number one thing that has got us to where we are?
Lists.
That's true. But what's the more number one thing?
Questions.
Jubia.
It's equality.
Equality?
Wow.
It's equality.
Oh, okay.
It's not equality. Far from
fuck. Humor.
It's evil.
Evil?
Oh. You can't get to 250 episodes without having
That's 250, not even including the Patreon.
Not even including
that. That's true.
That.
Not even including that at all. You gotta be, if you want to make it in this biz, you got to be evil.
That is you have even to be more so ruthless.
Ruthless, which is a subtype of evil.
I guess you're right.
Yeah. You got to be evil. And I thought for the 250th episode, because, you know, 250, that's a lot. Eventually, we'll have to stop maybe at 252 or 253.
Yeah.
When we run out of space on our hard drive.
We're
going to need some other people to fill in the gap when that happens. So I thought maybe that we could look at, you know, if you're looking to create your own podcast empire.
Yeah.
Can you click on the PowerPoint?
This is where we become influential.
How to act evil.
Whoa.
Oh my God.
So I found
this. Oh my God. Look at that super villain ass name.
Yeah, the name's already as evil as they come.
So here's the problem. I found this, How to Act Evil. It's about acting.
Oh.
It's about preparing for a theater role. And I was pretty disappointed by that because it's all stuff. How to read your lines.
Yeah.
How to do your costume, whatever. But.
Can you give us an example?
No, because it's all boring, and I didn't prepare it.
No, I mean, can you just do an off the dome evil monologue with evil acting?
No, because I'm not an actor.
Well, I am.
You could probably do it.
I am.
I don't know why you want me to do that.
What's my scenario? What's the scene?
Okay, so the scene is that you are the evil ice cream man. Okay. Basically, do you remember Max Keeble?
Yeah, we have two flavors today. Bone and blood. That's my evil ice cream song.
That was Woody the Woodpecker.
Yeah, that was Woody. That was Woody the Woodpecker.
What's that?
Can you do that? Okay, do that again, but do it more evil and more sinister.
Today, we only have two flavors, blood and bloody bone.
Okay, that was really good, but today is not an acting episode.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, all right.
That's what I was trying to say here. We're not doing How to Act Evil, but what we are doing from How to Act Evil, something that is attached to this WikiHow, is they have a really big Q&A section where people who found this article typed to ask their questions and the author answered them.
Okay.
So these are people who found this WikiHow, clearly did not read it.
Uh-huh.
And are just kind of asking freestyling questions based on the name.
They're asking Alina Bokoklovia.
Yeah. Bokovikova.
Bokovikova.
How do I become super evil? Acting selfishly without regard for the feelings of others will make you super evil.
196 said that was helpful.
41 people tried this and it did not work.
Yeah.
Work at all.
Yeah, I tried being selfish and it just didn't work at all. Tried cutting in line. I was not super evil.
Yeah, well, the sticking point is without regard for the feelings of others, because they probably cut in line and were like, sorry, I can't say that.
Yeah, I don't think you can teach evil, honestly.
Well,
no, you just, it's nurture.
Yeah.
It's nurture. So you taught.
No, it's nature.
Yeah.
It's nature.
I think it's maybe a combination of nature and nurture, but the nurture is opposite. I think it's opposite nurture, where someone has to be evil to you and not
the
teach
lack
you.
Lack of nurture. Yeah. Makes
Whoa.
You
up.
Yeah. And the lack of nature.
I think that kids who are put on baby formula instead of fed from their mother's teat are probably more than 50% more likely to become evil.
Definitely. 100%.
My nephew learned that he was breastfed recently and has been making fun of his brother for also being breastfed.
Well, that's a classic stones in a glass house kind of situation.
It's a pretty funny thing to do, though, I will say.
That is funny.
Yeah. I guess they got into an argument or something, and he said, "Yeah, well, you used to suck mom's boobs."
Sheesh!
Damn,
that's
how
fire.
Do you come back from that? Yeah. I guess you did too.
Then you're not winning. Then you're just both on the same level. Like there's no point even saying.
No, I didn't. I pretended.
I pretend. I put it behind my mouth and went.
Can I have a high doll-like voice and make it sound creepy? It is difficult to make a high voice sound creepy, but it can be done. Practice speaking in a squeaky voice, but weigh it down with a hoarse Darth Vader tone.
You can have a high doll-like voice.
Try this voice right now. Squeaky voice, but with a hoarse Darth Vader tone.
Hello. Hello.
Whoa.
That's creepy. Oh, my God. I'm getting shivers.
I'm
going to eat you.
Oh, my God.
That is scary.
I'm
going to
turn you into food.
Into fruit?
And your fruit, you're gonna become a berry.
This is
a
just
berry.
Gollum.
Yeah.
I just realized.
Yeah, it's just
not
Gollum.
That impressive because we. Like, wow.
Whoa.
I gotta eat you.
That's better. This is an original kind of character.
This is a frog.
No, this is
an
old
woman. I don't know.
This is an evil toad.
I'm an evil toad.
Say we have two flavors today: blood and bone.
Blood and bone. We have blood and bones.
See, I guess I found out I'm not an actor. I'm more of a writer.
We have blood and bones.
No, don't go really.
We have no ice cream.
What?
Don't do
Wait,
an actual
I've got it. I thought of an even better evil ice cream man
okay.
line.
Okay.
We have two flavors today, blood and bone, and we're out of both of them.
Oh, my God. Because that's the thing. I would eat a bone ice cream. Yeah. Blood, probably not.
Yeah, it depends
blood
on the type of
pudding,
blood.
Though.
I've never eaten that shit.
It's not good enough to be ice cream. It is food, but you wouldn't want to have ice cream on it, I guess.
There's an ice cream place around here that does black sesame.
How can I be an evil person's sidekick?
That's kind of nice.
Yeah.
No, that's.
I mean,
this guy's a loser.
Yeah.
If you're already gonna, if you already
be
decided,
evil, but also I want to be a sidekick.
Yeah. If you already decided to be evil, and then you're like, but also I want to be a henchman. It's like you don't even have the kind of confidence needed to be an evil mastermind.
Yeah.
Yeah. You kind of just become an evil person's sidekick through like years of abuse.
It's basically luck.
Yeah. Well, this person says, find someone evil and ask if they could use an evil henchman to aid them with their evil deeds. Say you'll do all the dirty work and you'll discard the bodies when asked.
Okay.
So, yeah, I mean,
that's pretty good.
I guess that's fine.
That's good advice.
That doesn't even tell you how to find. Like,
no, yeah.
What
how
really
do you find
need
an evil guy?
You need somebody, and it could be anybody. It doesn't have to be me, who makes maybe some kind of like Patreon series, web series of how to get your foot in the door of the industry. I mean that more than anything else.
Yeah.
Because this is fine advice,
a masterclass.
But how do you fucking find someone who's evil? They don't usually like telling people that they're evil. So
their evilness is actually displayed through their actions.
Which you need, or you need some kind of detector. But at that point, tell it to the police and make some money.
Yeah. Yep. Also, at that point, you're an inventor, and you could be evil.
Yeah,
exactly.
You don't really get a finder's fee for finding an evil person and reporting them to the police, because guess what? You'd be reporting the police all the time.
Yeah, I mean, we disagree on that, but yeah, sure.
Mm-hmm.
What should I eat if I'm evil? Eat anything that really makes your taste bud pop. Being evil, you could also ignore all the advice about sugar, additives, fats, and everything else. Or you could be extremely precise and weigh every calorie and eschew all sugars and fats. Really, eat as you want. You're evil and capable of thinking for yourself.
So this person is kind of saying that it's evil to be big and fat and eat whatever you want.
Yeah.
But like that's the thing. Don't you think somebody being more like the precision, like
well, it says,
how Hannibal Lecter eats like, who's that motherfucker that ate one pea on death row? It wasn't Hannibal Lecter. It was a real person.
That was...
Hannibal Lecter doesn't like peas. He likes peanuts.
He likes farva bean.
Skinny Fred.
Skinny Fred.
Yeah, he was stuffed. The
notorious serial killer.
With even one pee, he was stuffed.
Yeah, he had a small stomach.
Yeah
and
he drove him to evil.
He killed all workers at Burger King.
No, he wouldn't even kill him. He would cannibalize people, but just eat like their one fingernail and stuff. Yeah. And he'd be so stuffed.
One fingernail clipping.
Yeah, and he'd go, oh, God.
Oh, you filled me up.
Yeah.
Yeah. How can I be a dark princess?
That's a good question.
Look the part by wearing dark clothes. Do random evil acts, adopt an evil nickname, and be mysterious.
This is the most bullshit advice, man.
Yeah.
Okay, what's your advice for this question?
Okay, how
can I be a dark princess?
Here's how you do it. First of all, red and black dress.
Uh-huh.
Okay?
Uh-huh.
Tiara made out of maybe thorns or ivory. Some kind of evil material.
Ebony.
You know, or ebony.
Or Daedric stuff.
Some kind of Daedric, I don't know what that is, but yes, uh-huh. Something bad that is either white or black uh-huh. that has some kind of spell on it, first of all. So this is now, you need specifics, right?
You need a spell. You
do
need to
random
know
evil acts, give out parking tickets.
Uh-huh.
People are going to pay them. They're
what
not
going
to check.
The evil nickname?
Evil nickname?
Throw some out.
The queen of shit. The queen of ass.
The queen of ass. Yeah.
The queen of R-rated movies.
Yep.
Anything like that is going to be fine.
Yeah.
Because it just needs to be the queen of something.
Something evil.
Or the princess. Yeah. Princess of
Prejudice.
Yeah. Perfect, dude.
That would be a good supervillain
yes,
name.
Yes, dude. Princess fucking normalizing stuff.
Yeah.
Princess normalizing Diana. D-I-E.
Princess normalizing heterosexuality.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes.
Princess normalizing monogamy.
Exactly.
Princess vilifying.
Princess. Here's what a lot
princess
of people think is
eating polyamory. Snack foods
a lot
between
of
meals.
People, the thing is also, evil has changed every single year of the world.
Uh-huh.
So evil this year, somebody could say, guys, I'm Princess Christianity.
Uh-huh.
And honestly, a huge portion of the American population would say, get out of my face. I spit on you.
Uh-huh.
I actually want a chip into my left hand, some kind of mark of the beast.
And then half the other half of America is like, I want a chip in my left hand and then put it in my mouth. I'm a fatso. What the hell has happened to America?
Well, corn people syrup. Have been eating fat chips.
NAFTA.
Seed oil.
All that kind of
Princess
crap.
Seed oil.
That's
Princess
a great name.
Seed
QR
oil.
Codes. QR codes on... the restaurants, on the telephone poles, on computer ads.
And another thing, if I have to show my vax card before going into a restaurant, I'm dipping.
And what the fuck?
Yeah, dipping my fries in the fucking dip because I'm staying.
Yeah, because I like that.
And whose fucking idea was it to make the Roku app have a remote on it?
See? That? Mm-hmm. Oh,
let me use a regular remote. Oh. I don't want to use my phone.
Oh, okay. I got it, guys. You could be Princess Activision. Or Princess
Blizzard.
EA Games.
Yeah.
Something.
Princess Blizzard.
You could be Princess DRM.
Princess Blizzard. Princess
and
DRM.
See, that's the thing. Evil is so subjective.
It's really good.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Evil is so subjective that to some nerds in this world, they're going to hear Princess Activision, Princess DRM, assume that you're doing microtransactions, right?
Uh-huh.
So some people hate microtransactions. The other half hate microaggressions. And the other half love microgreens.
And the other half are microscopic.
Yeah, exactly. Some people are short. Some people are vegan. Mm-hmm. Some people are gamers. And some people don't like
microaggressions. It's a spectrum. It's all a spectrum, really. The spectrum of evil.
Yeah. And there's also billions of microscopic human beings in America, and they're called sperms. Yeah.
Yep.
Uh-huh. Life begins at sperm.
And you know what? Most of them die in a towel.
Mm-hmm.
Or a napkin.
A towel? Why would you waste a towel
on
your spunk?
I don't know.
Or waste your spunk on a towel.
You got to ask these evil people.
Yeah.
You got to ask these evil beings why they're putting loads in towels.
Oh, that's I would be Princess Planned Parenthood.
Yep.
Yeah.
PPP. PPP, PPP loans. A lot of evil people got PPP loans during the pandemic.
PPP loan wolf.
This is just facts, y'all.
Uh-huh.
Should I fight with everybody? Not necessarily. Insulting and mocking people will probably be enough.
Yeah.
Me and him got insulted and mocked the other day when we were
car. Before the show.
We got homophobically hate crime the other day.
Oh he called God. Us F-A-G-I-T and said he would put his cock
he said
in our
put his
asses
dick in
because
our asses.
We were gay.
And
he wasn't saying it politely or propositioning you in a polite
no.
way.
No.
So that's the thing. I said,
he said, hey, man.
Yeah,
and then that's the word.
Yeah,
that's the word that he would say.
In your motherfucking ass.
Well, maybe his voice just sounds like that. He might have just been asking.
That's what I'm saying. He had a gay accent, and he was like, "I'm gonna put your dick in my motherfucking ass."
He said, he said he was gonna put our dicks in his ass. That's what it
really?
Was.
Really?
It was some. I think he said both.
He said
I'm gonna do it both ways.
Yeah,
I think he said he was gonna do it both ways, but we were
walked around my car a couple times.
He also did see us unloading like costumes and
we looked a little gay.
Yeah. What's gay about costumes?
We did have a sword, though. We could have done something.
The entire world wears costumes at least one day a year.
That's what we should have done. Yeah. We should have challenged him.
On guard.
But basically, we both flighted instead of fighted him.
Uh-huh.
But
did you find him to be evil?
I think he maybe was.
Did you find him to be evil? Yes or no?
It depends.
Yes or no?
He would be evil
No. Say yes or no.
I think he was evil.
Because if you're saying no, that means that maybe he did have to fight with everybody. Maybe insulting and mocking isn't enough.
Yeah. It wasn't
maybe
enough.
In today's America, maybe it's not enough.
You have to resort to physical
violence. You have to fight with everybody. Everybody.
But he was also kind of an old guy.
Sure.
We probably could have fucked him if we wanted to.
Yeah.
But we really didn't want to that bad.
No, we had to go. We had a lot of we had to set up for that show.
I think the only thing that either of us said was, I said, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what you should say.
That's all you can say, right?
Yeah.
You can't
say, but then
like,
if you say okay, it's like, maybe he'll mistake it as like the go ahead.
But go ahead, man. I don't care. As long as we're done by 8 o'clock, I have to load
in
for this show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can do whatever to me. I'm fine with it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
What if I am evil, but I want friends and no one likes me?
Huh.
People generally don't like bad or evil people. The purpose of the article is to help you act evil for fun while pretending to be a character, not to actually become an evil person in your everyday life. If you want to have friends, you should be nice, unless you can find other people who are also evil. Most evil people like to work alone and not with the help of people, but that is totally your choice.
Why?
I love
this
that this is like first half being like doing like, listen, this article, it's not real. It's about acting. You should be nice to people. Unless you're with other evil people, then you can be evil.
What? I don't understand. If this person's already evil, why are they even looking at this fucking article? They should be writing the article.
Good point.
True.
My two cents.
But yeah, if you're evil, you have to have evil friends or else you'll have a war on your hands.
That's
true. You would not be getting along with folks.
Or you could have a good friend and keep them close, but be secretly evil.
But keep them closer. Yeah.
The most evil thing you can do is actually, I think, maybe be evil, right?
For sure.
But also 100%. Have a second life where you are nice, a la Barry.
Do you think evil guys get on World of Warcraft and they play the good guys?
Yes.
Yeah.
Because they want to feel
because
like,
they're so because evil.
Whenever
in person.
I play an MMO or any kind of RPG, I always go full evil because of how good I am.
Uh huh.
Right. So I'm always I have gray skin. I'm playing the Old Republic, and I'm saying, Bastila, you're gonna be my evil queen.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. I'm not helping them. I hate Carthonassus. But if a good guy plays Knights of the Old Republic, he's probably got a blue lightsaber, or a bad guy, he's got a blue lightsaber.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Right? I'm so
it's
evil,
about
I have
experimentation.
Horns. I have horns growing out of my head,
uh-huh.
Which is how it should. God should have made real life work as well, by the way.
Yeah. Will any tattoos make me evil?
Yes.
It depends on what kind of tattoos. You could research evil-looking tattoos, but keep in mind that a tattoo is permanent, so you want to make sure you'd want it forever.
See, I got all these evil tattoos on me.
I think tattoos
See,
are pretty
it says
evil.
Dr. Evil right
True.
There.
True. You should have just gotten evil tattooed. That would have been a much that would have actually
yeah,
been a
that
cool
would have been
tattoo.
Hard.
No,
yeah,
this is kind of goof. This is goofy.
It's goofball.
What's goofy it's about getting
goof,
Dr. Evil tattooed on you?
This is hipster.
That's not hipster.
This is a hipster.
It's giving
tab.
Meme account.
It's a little meme-ish. This is like it
it's
could
giving
be
meme Wednesday.
Well,
this would
it
be
was
posted.
The first. It was the first tattoo that I got, tattoo. So that I wouldn't be scared of them.
So you got Dr. Evil.
Dr.
Evil makes me think of a good guy.
This is
eventually
getting, you're
in the end.
Cover this up one day.
I don't think I will.
Did you feel my cold hand?
Your hand, Jesus Christ!
Is my hand cold?
Yeah, why are your both my hand feel
it's
mine.
Cold in here.
Yours are warmish.
Mine
yours are
so
very
warm.
You have a temperature regulation problem, and that's why you always turn the AC
no,
to
we,
zero
I
degree.
Think, I think us with cold hands are the ones that are bad.
No.
Well, whatever.
I think I do have a
I have
temperature
normal
regulation
and my
problem
limbs don't turn purple at any time of my life every day.
I
really?
Sweat whenever I walk, even in the fall.
Whenever you walk?
Whenever I walk.
My skin turns gray and Frankensteinian.
Yeah, you do. You've got some color right now, though. Where'd you
Frankenstein's
go?
Monsterian. Is
I'm having
green.
Yeah. You're heaven? Is that what you said?
I'm heaven.
To gamers, that
what
means
kind
something
of,
else.
What kind of music will make me evil? try heavy bass dubstep songs. Skrillex is a good place to start.
I would say try Gwar.
Yeah, try Ghost.
Yeah, that'll make you evil.
Ghost
as fuck,
is going
to
turn you evil real quick.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. Anything as well as horror movie soundtracks.
Yeah.
Assault on Precinct 13.
Yeah, the Twilight Zone theme song. You're entering a dimension.
Exorcist theme song.
That'll make you scared or evil. There's no difference to me.
There isn't much difference.
People tend to act evil when they are scared.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Especially
the most evil looking people are actually sometimes the nicest.
I disagree.
No. Yeah, I don't agree either.
No, I agree.
You agree?
I mean, I don't agree.
You agree with him disagreeing against you. I agree against you.
What other advice do they have?
Would dressing in a more edgy way make me evil? No, it will likely not.
What does it even mean to be edgily dressed? You wear a stud?
You wear a studded belt.
Black shirt?
You wear a black shirt. I almost wore a black shirt today, and I said, I'm going to look like Steve Jobs. I'm not going to do
that. You have a shirt that says evil on it.
Do I?
E.VIL2. Oh, yeah. What is that?
I don't know. I just thought it was funny that it said evil on it.
That is, what, it's like a little picture of a dragon doing something on the back?
It's got some Godzilla thing on it. Yeah. I don't fucking know.
How can I be evil if everyone thinks I'm cute and sweet?
This is a brag.
This is what I ask every
this
day.
This is a
the
brag.
Funny part. I think I only put in one of these, but there's like five of these questions. I think this is the same person who asked about the doll high-pitched voice.
Oh, okay.
And they have a bunch of questions. They're like, what if I'm cute and I only dress in pink? Can I be evil? There's a bunch of stuff like that.
You can't.
If you want to look the part, try perfecting the smirk. That cunning smile when you know something they don't. That look on your face when you suddenly hatch a perfectly evil plan.
This is like asking, I'm 4'8". Can I make it in the NBA? No.
Neither of these. What do you guys think of my smirk?
You look like a bird and you look like a pirate.
And pirates are evil. Pirates are evil.
Pirate, parrot.
That's not a smirk.
That's not a smirk at all.
You look like Bill Skarsgård just then.
Wait, how was mine? I'm changing mine to a smirk.
I look like it.
No. This is not a real smirk. You look ugly. You look like Igor. No, you look ugly as fuck. You both look like shit, honestly.
You look like
shit.
What
about this one?
No, don't. That one's not evil. No, you don't. You're incapable of an evil face. You have an ugly one.
What about this one?
What? Your just face is ugly. You can't do any of these.
Is this face evil?
This is kind of bitchy. You're coming a bitch face. You look like you're coming.
You only tried one face and it was bad, so you don't really have any like watch to this. Stand on.
No,
that's not evil at all. That's conscious and intelligent.
That's like English teacher's Facebook profile picture. When you you find your English teacher on Facebook, and then his profile picture is him sitting at his computer, like,
how can I make my cat and dog evil too?
You. This is what you need. You need a summoned pet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well,
I'm a summoned
your
pet.
Cat
my
is probably
evil
already, but your dog might take a little more work. You may want to consider giving your pets evil-looking accessories like a dark spiked collar, sinister-looking tags, or a bandana. Uh-huh. If your pets are newly adopted, try giving them creepy or evil-sounding names like Vex or Crimson.
I know a dog in this neighborhood called Necro.
That's sick.
Yeah.
What kind of dog?
He's a German Shepherd. He's like an all-black German Shepherd. Damn. He's very sweet, though.
But that's sick.
Yeah,
that's
cool. And his owner's like this like Norwegian like black metal guy.
Yeah,
it's
that's
cool.
Very tight. It's cool. That's really cool.
Yeah,
that's extremely cool. Would wearing latex make me look more evil? Yes,
yeah.
Latex and leather are pretty good choices for looking evil.
Yeah, because of doctors, they're wearing latex
gloves.
That's a good point. That is a really good point.
Yeah, and they're wearing the leather lab coat.
Uh huh.
Well,
white leather.
The doctor I go to.
If they're Steve Martin and fucking the big Plant movie.
Yeah, Plant the movie.
Plant. Planet
they should have called it Plant the movie.
They should.
That is basically
that
the number one Plant movie.
Here's what I
There's no other
that
movie that's more Plant than that movie.
It's true. Here's what I would have called that movie though.
There's
reverse the reverse vegetarian.
That's good.
The vegetable that eats a person.
That would be a good tagline. The
revenge of the reverse vegetarian. That's what I would have.
Revenge of the plants.
Revenge of the reverse vegetarian is a better name.
Yeah, that's true.
Because a reverse vegetarian would be a plant.
People would be like, "What is that? Is that the one about the tomatoes or the plant?"
What tomato?
I would call
Attack
the movie,
of the Killer Tomatoes.
I would try and class it up a little bit, and I would title it "In Which the Plant Terrifies."
Oh, and sings.
God damn.
In Which the Plant Terrifies, the musical.
And here's what I would have put at the end of the movie: Finn.
And I would have put at the beginning of the movie players in alphabetical order.
Yeah, yeah. I would have done all that shit.
Yeah,
but they won't let me make movies.
Would a luxury car fit my evil persona? It depends on the character you're playing. It could, though.
I like the one person that said this is not helpful. That must have been the dude who like owns like a Mercedes-Benz dealership.
No, it would have been that's a hater. That's somebody with a junker jalopy style car.
Yeah.
And it wasn't me. I don't have a jalopy. Have a jalopy. I fixed my mirror, you have a so jalopy. I do not have a jalopy. I put
you
a new mirror
You have
on.
A jalopy.
I do not.
I want to be very scary and possessed. What should I do?
Acting possessed needs a lot of work. Make sure the person you want to scare is a bit of the jumpy type. If the person doesn't seem very jumpy, focus on their weaknesses and try to scare them using that.
Focus on their weaknesses. This one, the answer isn't so good, but I do really like the question. I want to be very scary and possessed.
You don't choose to be possessed, buddy.
No, yeah.
The devil chooses
you. If you want it, you're not going to get it. A watch pot never boils.
You can try. Did you guys ever play the midnight game?
No.
Where you do a salt.
I did play the midnight game a few times.
You put salt on the ground?
You said the midnight game where you do a salt?
You do a salt. Well, he interrupted me. A salt circle is what I was going to say. But a salt would also be an evil style game.
Salt your circle?
No, my circle is not open for assaulting.
I tried to play the midnight game. I never got any points, though.
My circle. Put it in my circle.
My circle.
Oh, that's funny.
Is being evil a subculture?
Yes.
Evil? No. Evil is a mindset, not a subculture.
Really?
There's no single way to look or act evil.
Hippies are evil.
Hippies are evil.
They are so evil.
Hippies are evil, and then usually punks are kind.
It's kind of reverse what you would think.
Yeah.
You would think that hippies would be kind, but they like drugs and premarital
and
stuff.
And stealing.
Hardcore guys are straight edge.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Hardcore guys
and as
are
long
the
as
exact
you,
opposite
as
of
long
hippies.
As you only pay attention to what they do during the day.
Yeah.
And when they're not in the presence of people who are younger than them,
yep. Then they're
upstanding citizens.
Yeah, they all work at
they do acrobatics.
Yeah, they all they work drive at Trader the bus. Joe's. They work at Trader. They all work at Trader Joe's. Uh-huh. They wear that Hawaiian shirt.
Yep. Uh-huh.
Then guys, they take it off.
They all wear watches.
Yep.
They don't look at their phone. They look at their watch.
Uh-huh. I've been feeling for a minute that the tide is turning on Trader Joe's, and Trader
what?
Joe's has now become.
Has it fallen?
I think Trader Joe's is cringe.
Yes.
I'm sorry. I don't like saying that. I don't want to have to say this.
This is the kind of thing you'll only hear here. Yeah.
But as a cultural commentator, Trader Joe's.
It's time to call it. I'm ready. I've seen
I'm
enough.
Ready to
I'm
call
ready
it.
To call it.
It's over. It's over. Trader Joe's is cringe. Fuck you, Joe. I mean, Joe's over.
Joe,
it's
Ming,
Jover.
Jose.
Jover party.
It's Jover,
all
mate.
Of them.
Yeah.
I don't care how good that everything in the elote dip is. I don't care how convenient the pork belly is. It's over. I'm going somewhere else. I'm taking my business to Aldi.
No, you're,
I'm going to Aldi. You're, is Aldi over?
You know too much about Trader Aldi, Joe's to be dissing
buddy,
it. You clearly are a patron.
You're asking if there. Aldi was over? Aldi never began.
Damn.
Aldi's, Aldi's nuts in your face.
How many?
Aldi's.
Aldi never began.
Yeah.
And there's no
Aldi never began.
We're never doing it's by the way, when I say Trader Joe's is over, every single alternative supermarket is
Whole
over.
Whole Foods. We're going local.
Aldi. No, we're not going local.
We're doing
whatever the big chain supermarket is. Stop and Shop, Harris Teeter, Publix, Kroger. Uh-huh.
Market Basket.
Market Basket, nah.
Market Basket has been a little over, but they could be back soon.
But right for now, it's over.
For now.
We do not, and anything, by the way, anything that is local to an area is over as well.
Yep.
Well, Stop and Shop is local to the Northeast.
But it's not like people don't have pride.
Harris Teeter.
From now on, we are only going to any supermarket where they have one in every town in America.
Okay. Yep.
If there's even one town that doesn't have it, we're not going
Piggly
there.
Wiggly is not funny
Shaw's,
anymore.
You're done.
Every supermarket.
Or it all has to be owned by the same company.
Hannaford supermarkets.
Walmart grocery stores are back, is what I'm saying.
Target.
And you can actually, and here's how back they are. You can actually buy Wagyu beef at a Walmart. Uh-huh. Yeah, so that's huge, guys.
You know what else you can get at Walmart?
Shoes.
Every other stuff in your house. You can get a curtain rod.
Yep.
And Wagyu steak. And beer, depending on the area.
We're
and
going to Walmart.
They have good deals on movies.
DVDs.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
And, hey, Trader Joe's, here's why you're over, by the way.
No DVDs.
No DVDs, first of all. But also, guys.
No CDs.
Hey, guys, if I'm buying an avocado, I don't need to see a picture of the farmer. I don't need to know his story. Uh-huh. I don't need to know that he's been farming avocado since he was 15 with his family. Shut the fuck up.
And here's another thing, Trader Joe's. why do you have all these parodies around the store?
Yep.
Fatality. Why do you have these parodies that say Empire Strikes whatever, some kind of thing?
Hey, Trader Joe, nice chalkboards. How about I outline you in chalk when I kill you? Bruh. Yep.
Outline.
Outline you in chalk. That's right.
And you said outlaw.
I'm going to outlaw you. You are an outlaw now also, Joe. Uh-huh. And I'm pointing to a camera we don't have. But
we left all the cameras in Caleb's car.
Yep, that's why we have just two cameras today. Now I'm pointing at this one. But
because of the show we did.
And Trader Joe, you have a fearless flyer. I will become the fearsome flyer.
Uh-huh.
And I will haunt your store with wings.
And Costco, welcome back.
Costco's back.
Costco is
Sam's Club. Sam's Club. Welcome back.
Sam's Club is still technically Walmart.
BJ's, guess what? You never left because it's always been funny to say your name.
But Trader Joe's.
Trader Joe's.
You poor bastard.
Oh, little Trader Joe's.
Hawaiian shirts. You still think that's funny? You're making me gag.
Look, you're making Cameron throw up.
If you want to switch all the girls to bikinis and all the guys to suits, though, you will be back.
You will be back.
You will be back.
That's the only bargain you have
If you have a corporate hose and CEO's party.
Yep.
Every day.
You will be back.
You will be back.
But for now, you're done.
You're done.
And that's enough on Trader Joe, and we can finish now.
Yeah. We can finish now.
Was that all the slides gone?
I don't remember.
Let's check.
We'll check really quickly.
Can I wear fancy clothes and have a fancy hairstyle when acting evil? Can I wear makeup as well?
No.
Of course. In fact, that will up the evil factor. I think that fancy clothes is okay, but a fancy hairstyle is not evil.
I agree. Unless you're some kind of dark judge.
That's a wig, though.
That's a hairstyle.
Yeah.
Is the evil laugh cliche when acting evil? Not necessarily. Just try to put your own spin
on it.
Let's all
put our own
unique
spin on it.
Okay, ready? That's a classic. There's no
spin.
Okay,
okay.
Wait, I got it.
That was good.
I got one. Are you ready?
Yeah. That's an evil. If you know somebody who laughs like that, they're evil.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, have a donkey.
How do I imply I'm evil without being evil? Dress like you are evil. The way you dress can imply that you are evil, but you could be the nicest person ever.
Here's my implications.
That's just evil.
My implications. What if you maybe put it on your ID card?
Here's my implication. Here's my assumption.
What if they put that on your driver's license when they ask, what's your height? What's your sex?
Evil.
What's your age?
My
are
age is 666.
Are you evil or good?
Uh-huh.
And you could just say, well, I'm evil.
Yeah. I came here for a more broad context than theater. With that in mind, do you have any more tips on becoming a villain? Villains never think they're the bad guy. They never see themselves as sadistic or wrong. They're the hero of their own story. Keep that in mind.
That's wrong.
I think this next one might be the last one. No. Do I have to wear accessories like a choker? My mom doesn't allow me to. Here we go. This is the last one. What if you accidentally murder people while acting evil? Will it still be considered a crime after you stop being evil? And the person says, of course, murder is murder. If you're not legally insane, you'll be charged with murder.
Oh, wow. My God. So there's no such thing as they got rid of the evil defense. The evil defense. Your Honor, my client was evil at the time.
He was evil at the time, but he's not anymore. Murder.
But he's become nice.
Oh,
he was
God.
Just acting evil when he did the murder.
That is kind of
it was an accident.
A lot of evil villains in movies kind of get off on that at the end. If they are turned to the good side because they realize that it's wrong to be an environmentalist or whatever.
Yeah.
Why are so many evil villains environmentalists also?
It is funny.
Why is that going on? What's going on with
eco-terrorism?
That? Yeah.
Yeah, why is that being evil? That seems like it's nice.
Well, they're just guys who blow stuff up.
Yeah, true.
Well, they're blowing up bad stuff.
I'm an ego terrorist.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's right. You figure out what that means. All right. Goodbye.
All right. If you
what day?
Shareholder meeting is on Monday
next Monday.
24th.
Is it the 24th?
And if you want to see me open for Dan Licata in Austin, Texas, I will be there the weekend of the 28th. 28th and the 29th is two shows. There's a real good poster that my old roommate Neil drew where Dan is Bam and I am Fat Phil from CKY3.
You don't need to plug the poster when you plug the show.
I like the poster.
Plugging the poster? All right, I have to pee. You can keep plugging stuff up.
And then on the 26th, there's a show with the Pitbull impersonator. He's hosting the show. And then I think maybe the Sunday, 2 days before this, 3 days before this, will be my birthday, the 23rd, the day before the shareholder meeting. If you don't have anything planned for my birthday, guess what? You will get struck by the back of my hand. And Cameron will be at my birth.
No, I'm not.
Have you guys ever tried remote viewing?
Yes.
Yeah, Jubio's doing it right
now.
Did
you succeed?
Yeah, I actually can see my bedroom with my eyes closed at all times.
I'm going to try it right now.
Okay, where are you going to go?
Where should I go?
I don't know.
You don't go, you see.
Where should I see?
Okay.
Try the surface of the moon.
Okay.
And usually you draw it.
Well, I'm not very good at drawing, Cameron. My art form is my words.
Okay, then describe.
I see some seriously white ground. And okay. I see a bunch of black crap out there, which some might call space.
Okay.
And wait, what's that? I'm seeing a pale blue dot. Oh, great.
It's a dot?
A pale.
that moon is very far away.
I'm seeing some pale blue. I didn't say which moon I was on.
Oh.
Oh, he's on Neptune.
I guess you didn't say you were on a moon at all.
Now that I think about it, I'm on a moon. And I'm seeing a pale blue dot. Oh, but wait, what am I seeing on the pale blue dot? Instead of love, I'm seeing hate, and I'm seeing racial prejudice and sexism, and worse of all, misogyny, and also kids being unfairly treated by their parents. And also there's five or six green monsters all around me. And they are making something, some kind of giant weapon.
Weapon?
Yep. And also I can tell that one of them is the most popular of the six because the other ones are kind of just listening to what he's saying, and also he's the tallest one.
But does he have like a special kind of hair?
He has an Elvis hairdo. Yeah. He has an Elvis greasy
that style
hairdo. That slick back Elvis rock and roll
that we
style.
All know and
oh
love.
Oh my God. Are yep. the other ones bald or do they all have their own distinct hairstyles that define their personality?
Well, basically one of them has... Okay. So there's six of them. One of them has an Elvis hair.
Okay.
One of them has very long hair.
Uh-huh.
One of them has shorter-ish hair.
But does he have glasses?
One of them has a bob. Very kind of cute.
Okay.
With a bow?
And then three of them, or the remaining two, have no hair at all.